Hello, everybody. It's OCD Mikey, Hi-Fi Guy here. And I am going to give you a little feature here, featurette, whatever you call it, to talk about the JEFF ROWLAND Model 125. JEFF ROWLAND is a brand that I have come to know and love over the years. Fantastic product. Built like a brick, you know what. Quality is consistent every time. Never heard a JEFF ROWLAND piece that did not sound good. Now, I'm here to demo this piece so you can hear how good it sounds and not listen to anybody talking whatever the hell they talk, because listening is believing. And so what I've done on purpose here is I've teamed it up with a reference DAC. It's my $22,000 Playback Designs MPD-8, the best DAC I've heard yet to date. I've heard almost all of them. And so I know there's nothing wrong upstream. People may say, oh, well, of course, you're playing it with a, you know, expensive DAC. It's going to sound good. Well, look, the reason for doing that is so that if you, anybody that listens to the JEFF ROWLAND 125 and says it's not phenomenal sounding, means it's upstream. Because I'm going to show you how, when you have the front end straightened out, the thing is phenomenal. So if it doesn't sound phenomenal, it's your front end. Okay, I'm taking care of that front end thing right now by giving the best front end I know of. That way you know it's not the amp if it doesn't sound good to you. It's that means it's the front end, my friend. So we will do that. I am making it very simple, in fact, for us to listen. And I am going to the left and right. Now, let me see. I have to get a new camera here. Okay. So, anyway, so it's a little fuzzy, but that'll change soon. Anyways, so we're listening to the reference floor standards. These are made in America. They are no longer going to be $6,000, I found out today, because now, because of the world and how screwed up it is and how our dollar is getting worth less and inflation's going crazy, they will no longer be $6,000. I just sold my final pair. I guess I would sell these maybe, I don't know. I need a pair of box speakers. I can't sell these. If someone wants them, you can tell me, but whatever. Anyways, bottom line is, so we're listening to only this. These two speakers only. Okay. They're double 9-inch drivers, a 5 1/4 on the mid, and a 1-inch soft dome tweeter. Okay. So it's not like all we've got is the DAC, using that as a volume control, the amp, which is just this little guy right here. Speaker cables going out to two speakers, okay? So that's all we're listening to. We got no subwoofers in the mix, no panels, nothing, just these two that you can see right in front of you. So I will proceed with the, there we go, do it like that. I will proceed with the demo, and we can listen to this fantastic amplifier. I think this is the perfect piece for someone wanting to get into the real true hi-fi, okay? Now, I'm talking about Hi-Fi Tribe Mikey Hi-Fi, not the hi-fi that they peddle to you in the magazines and all that other crap. That's a lot of times junky. And this, anything that I represent, that I put my name on, it's been through the gauntlet. I'm picky. I don't settle for crap. I don't sell chi-fi. I sell American-made stuff or European. And nowadays, I've got European stuff and Italian-made stuff that is the same price or less than the Chinese stuff. So, and it sounds better. So, anyways, let's get on with the JEFF ROWLAND piece here, made in America. I'll go over the build a little in a second, but let's listen to some music, shall we? Hold on.
Oh,
Some gangsta shit. I'm just kidding, cause you know I'm giving love to them motherfucking money making dubs. Sitting here, I mean, clearly what I'm pointing out is that if you buy this amplifier to build yourself a hi-fi rig, you will have an amplifier that can stand with a $22,000 DAC. $10,000 speakers. I sell them for $6,000, but they're clearly $10,000 speakers. So what I'm trying to show is that you could build around this amplifier. This amplifier is $3,300. I am going to be doing my first round for my beloved hi-fi tribe. The Hi-Fi Tribe, you go on to 11stereo.com, sign up for the Hi-Fi Tribe. You will receive an email that I have coming up. I will make available 10 of these pieces, and I will put out some terms for these 10 that you will, I don't know how to say it without sounding stupid, you know, let's just say be there when the email comes in, because if you want to start building a real hi-fi rig and you want to do it with Mikey, I will absolutely make sure you get everything that you signed up for. So not this weekend, but next weekend on Saturday, that's when I'll send the email out. There will be 10 of these available. Only the people with the link will be able to get to this offer. And it's only to my tribe. So you got to go to 11stereo.com and sign up. Okay, so here is the Roland one model 125. As you can see, the front panel, or this is a block of aluminum, actually. This whole thing is milled out of a block of aluminum. The bottom is a bottom cover, but once you take this off, this is all milled out like they do in typical Roland fashion. This is made just like the big amps. So the same finish, as you can see, this is spectacular finish. No one else has this in the industry. Only Jeff does. You can see how there's these lines that show up in the, and it's part of the machining. It's actually really, it's almost like very lightly scalloped in a very, very slight way. But it's gorgeous. Everything else, nice black aluminum. It's also scalloped across the top, as you can see. Probably got my little oily fingerprints, but I can wipe those off. It comes in a velvet bag, and then in its box, so it's nice and protected. It has one single power button on the front that you just press, and then it'll illuminate blue. Press it again, it goes off, and that is the only control that you have on the... Actually, you have a main power. It goes into standby. On the back, you'll see you've got a main power switch right over here, like that, and then you actuate it on the front for to bring it out of standby. Here is a remote trigger, which is pretty cool. If you have the preamp or something else that you turn on, it'll automatically turn the amp, take it out of standby with that remote trigger. As you can see how deep this is in there, look at that. Okay, so that's not just a metal rear plate. Like any other amp you get would have a thin rear metal plate. You can see how deep that thing is in there. So it that shows how it's just, it's milled out of here. I should actually take off the back, but you can just trust me on that. Right here, you can also see, here's the plate for the binding post. Look at, look, you know, at an angle in here with this, and you can see how deep that is. That's at least 1/4 inch thick plate for holding the binding post. Now, these binding posts are Cardis patented binding posts. They are extremely secure. You can crank them down nice and hard, and they really get a good grip on your spades. Now, if you want to put bananas in, you can. You simply drill the top where these two, where that plus and minus are, and you come in the side on that thing, then you can just put your bananas in the top and press them against the tips of these. This screws just like that. They're in nice recessed grooves. So these are phenomenal binding posts. As you see, there's balanced inputs only. JEFF ROWLAND gear is all balanced. It's always balanced. The older stuff might have been some single-ended, but everything is differential at this point. This amplifier you can bridge. So it's 125. That's where it gets the model number from, and is 125 watts per channel, or you can bridge them for 500 as a monoblock. So you get two of these, and you can bridge. You can have two of these. You can have a pair of mono JEFF ROWLAND 125s for less than many stereo amps. $3,300 bucks, so $6,600 gives you a pair of 500 watt monoblocks. When you switch this, you just go from stereo to mono. It's just a flick of this switch. You have a little light when the mono goes on. When you switch it to mono, you see that illuminate. Then you know you're in mono. And you just use this input over here. It's pretty easy to see, mono input. And then you just put your positive and negative. It's easy to understand. Here's your BTL input, positive, negative, just like that on these two. So you tap off each of them. This actually holds both, left and right. Some people get confused. They think this is red. And it is when this is a monoblock, it's red and white. But when it's a stereo amp, red and white for, you know, left and right. So that's how that works. It's a very stout amplifier. It's heavy, you know. When you get this thing, you are going to know you are owning a piece of American hi-fi. It is very much JEFF ROWLAND in every sense of the word. This back, the gear that's on here, the hardware that's on here, the all the plates, the chassis is exactly like my $17,500 monoblocks over there. They're actually stereo amps. Same exact build, okay? JEFF does not skimp out when he makes his entry level. A lot of companies will skimp out, but he does the same exact thing. So this is, in my opinion, a phenomenal piece to start a killer little hi-fi rig. And you just heard how it sounds. So I'm going to help some people start their hi-fi rigs up. And that's coming next week. And be on the lookout. If you're in the tribe, you're going to be getting an email. I'll tell you more about it. So anyways, just wanted to let you know about that. This is the JEFF ROWLAND 125, and it's coming soon to the Hi-Fi Tribe. See you.